Scoliosis is a curve that measures more than 10 degrees. There are different kinds of scoliosis. So the typical kind of scoliosis that people think about is the kind that the young teenage girl comes in with. That's called idiopathic scoliosis. What idiopathic means is it's a phrase that literally means, I don't know. It is an unknown cause. The second kind of scoliosis that I see is called congenital scoliosis. Now, these children were born with differences in their spine. So each spine bone should look like a square or a rectangle. Some of these children have bones that are shaped like triangles, or they have abnormal fusions in the way that their bones were separated or segmented prior to birth. Now, the third type of scoliosis is neuromuscular scoliosis. So my patients who use wheelchairs from muscular dystrophy, from spina bifida, from cerebral palsy, have differences in their muscle strength within their trunk, and they're prone to developing scoliosis. What happens is that during the growth spurt, all of a sudden those bones that were perfectly aligned develop a curvature between them. Bones don't change their shape, they simply curve one relative to the next. And so it mysteriously develops and nobody knows it's coming on. It can run in families. Scoliosis may cluster in a family. I had one family that I treated three of their children for scoliosis. That family clearly had the gene. But we also have children that nobody in the family has scoliosis and the child suddenly has developed this curvature and no one knows where it came from. So in Texas, our school nurses are frequently checking for scoliosis in the junior high years. They bend the kids forward and they're looking for differences in their ribs left to right. When they bend over, they look uneven. We may see a shoulder that's elevated or a waistline that's shifted, and those are all the clinical signs of scoliosis. So it's not an infrequent condition. Again, it's going to be more common in girls than in boys. It's going to be most common in the junior high and the high school ages. Well, I would say the common misconceptions about scoliosis are first and forward that it hurts. And it doesn't usually. Now, it doesn't mean you can't have back pain if you have scoliosis. The second misconception is that it needs to be operated on. There are actually many people who have scoliosis and the curves are mild enough that we don't need to do a surgical correction for their scoliosis. When I see a new patient for scoliosis, I outline the treatment options for them, and we basically have three. We can observe scoliosis. So if a curve is mild, we don't necessarily have to do anything about it. The second form of treatment that we offer is bracing. Bracing these days is used for the children that have curves, they're at risk for progressing, and they're actively growing. The brace works during the period of time that the spine is growing. Finally, we do have surgery. And surgery is indicated in those children who have curves that are too big to brace. And we know that going forward throughout their life, they're going to continue to worsen. So we want to operate on those curves and stabilize them so that the curve doesn't worsen during adulthood. Yeah, I want them not to be afraid. The minute you hear there's something wrong with your spine, the immediate reaction is, I need to have surgery, I need to wear a back brace, my life is changing, and I'm not going to be able to do the things I love to do anymore. And 99% of the time, that is just not true. Look at your kids' backs. If you see that their shoulders are off, bring that up to your pediatrician. Have your pediatrician double check you. So be observant, and if you see a difference, come on in and see an orthopedic surgeon for an evaluation.